Well, hello there. I bet you didn't know that the colour of your PS5 indicator tells you what the PlayStation is doing, or that your PS5 has a secret internet browser. This is 40 PS5 Secrets. These videos are all about you, so you should subscribe to keep the stream of PS5 knowledge coming. Let's get into it. 40. The PS5 Light Bar. PS5 Light Bar has 8 different states that tell you what the PS5 is doing, the rarest of which is flashing red. And if your PS5 does this, then you're in trouble, as it's overheated and you'll likely need to send it to Sony for servicing. You can avoid this by keeping your PS5 in an open, unconfined space. 39. Secret Browser. The PS5 has a secret red browser. Wait, what? Where is it? Well, it's hidden. To access the secret web browser, you will need to go to Game Base, pick any friend, go to text chat, type google.com into the chat, then select google.com and press X, and there is the secret browser. From here you can search anything that you might need. 38. Pinning. The secret browser of the PS5 is a little bit clunky, however, there is one great way that you can use it. If you need a guide, go to youtube.com or any other guide website, bring up the guide you need, press options and then pin it to the side, and you can have the video guide present while you play your respective game. 37. Safe mode. I bet that you didn't know the PS5 has a safe mode that almost no one knows about. To access safe mode, you'll need to fully power down your PS5, and then press and hold the power button and keep holding until you hear the second beep. This is great for if you run into any trouble with the console, as you can troubleshoot it from here. 36. Clear cache. There's a way that you can increase the PS5 speed from within the safe mode menu. If you scroll down to clear cache, and then press X and then clear the cache, this will delete all the temporary files and junk data from the operating system, and it should increase the load times of games and within games. I would recommend doing this about once every 6 months. 35. HDMI device link. I bet that you didn't know that you can turn on and off your PlayStation and TV with just one button press, such that the TV will turn on when you press the PS button on the controller, and the PS5 will turn off when you press the off button on your TV remote. To enable this function, you need to go to Settings, System, HDMI, and make sure all of the HDMI device link settings are enabled. 34. The TV remote. Here's another great thing you can do with HDMI device link enabled. You can use your TV remote on your PS5 just like so. So there's no need for that crappy overpriced media remote, just use the TV remote instead. 33. The PS app. The PS app is an incredibly underrated tool that you can use to enhance your play and save time. You can download the app from the iStore or the Google Play Store, and you can message your friends, talk to them over the phone with party chat, you can delete games on your PlayStation, you can set games to download while you're at work or school so they'll be ready, including lengthy updates for when you get home, and there'll be no waiting around. 32. SSD. This might be well known, however, not all SSDs were built the same. There's some things you should know. The SSD you buy needs to conform to the following requirements. The best SSD you can buy for the PS5 is the Seagate FireCuda 530 with a heatsink, which has a sequential read speed of up to 7,300 megabytes a second. You also need to put the SSD cover back on once you've installed the SSD, as this affects the way the cooling system works. Without the cover, the cooling is less effective. 31. HDD. You can also increase your storage using a USB hard disk drive. Using a HDD, you can store games and media. You can play media that you've downloaded from within the storage menu if they're in MP4 format. And you can run PS4 games from a HDD. You can store PS5 games on a HDD, which is useful if your internal storage is full, but you cannot play PS5 games from a HDD, as the load rate is far too slow. The drive needs to have a sequential read speed of 5500 megabytes per second to run PS5 games. 30. Cloud storage. Fancy playing one of your old games from the PS4 generation, but you don't want to start again, or perhaps taking advantage of New Game Plus? You can download your old game saves from the cloud storage if you're a PS Plus user. Go to PS Plus, cloud storage, and then download the respective game save. 29. Power settings. There's a few useful things you can do in the power settings. Go to settings, system, power saving, and then you can set the time limit for when your PS5 and your DualSense will turn off after inactivity, which is useful if you forget to turn the PS5 off, or if you go AFK to save the DualSense battery. 28. Sleep mode settings. While you're in power saver settings, go to features available in sleep mode, and make sure the USB ports are always turned on in standby mode, which is going to allow you to charge your accessories while the PS5 is turned off, and the PS5 can auto download updates while in standby, and also enable us to use features on the PS app we talked about earlier. You can also leave applications running in suspension, so on launch you're automatically put straight back into the game and you don't have to wait for it to load. 27. 3D audio. The PS5 supports 3D audio for both compatible headsets and speakers. This is a great in-game feature, as you can hear where in-game objects are in relation to you in a full 3D scope and not just left and right. To enable and calibrate this function, go to Settings, Sound, 3D for TV speakers, or 3D for headphones, and follow the on-screen instructions. instructions to enable and calibrate the function. 26. Chat transcription. Chat transcription can be a useful tool if you're better at reading than hearing, or if you have a hearing impairment. To enable this function, go to Settings, Accessibility, Chat Transcription, and enable it. You will now see what other players are saying in-game, and what you say can be read aloud to other players. 25. The mute button. Need a little peace and quiet? You can easily mute all sounds from PS5 by holding down the mute button on the DualSense, and an icon will appear on the top right screen to show that all audio is muted, and the mute button will flash orange instead of being solid or off. 24. Game presets. You can set things like difficulty, view perspective, resolution, and subtitles to be preset for games within the PS5 settings, so you don't have to waste time messing about with them when you play a new game. Simply go to Settings, Save Data in Game/App Settings, Game Presets, and you can set your desired presets here, like irritating subtitles to be always off. 23. Quick button shortcuts. There are several ways you might not know that you can navigate the menu faster. For example, on the homepage, you can press triangle from any position to be instantly taken to the search icon, where you can quickly get to the profile and settings. From the games tab, you can press R1 to immediately swap to the media tab, and L1 to swap back to the games tab, and holding down the PS button will instantly take you back to the home screen. 22. The create button shortcuts. If like me, you're a content creator, a streamer, or you simply like to record your gameplay memories, then you'll like this one. You can change what the create button will do with different inputs. For example, I have easy video enabled, which allows me to record with a double tap of the create button, or to change what the create button does, go to settings, captures and broadcast, shortcuts for the create button, and from there you can see the different options for the create button. 21. Quick launch. Want to go back to a specific place in game or from cold launch? Well, if you press the PS button on launch to bring up the cards menu, PS5 will show you what you were last doing in game, and if you press the icon, it will launch you straight into that place or mission rather than you loading into the game menu. 20. Trophy tracking. Chasing that ever elusive platinum trophy? No problem, you can actively track your progress for trophies. To do this, press the PS button, go and go to trophy tracker, select the trophies you want to track. You can track up to 5, and now when you press the PS button, the PS5 will show you how close you are to achieving that trophies and the requirement to unlock it. 19. Quick menu customization. The quick menu is a very useful tool whereby you can quickly access almost anything you might need, like party chat or the internet settings. I bet you didn't know that you can customize this menu by adding functions that you use and hiding functions that you don't use. Simply press the PS button, then press options, and you can add and remove options from the quick menu. 18. Disc rescue. If for any reason your disc won't eject from the PS5, don't panic. The PS5 has a built-in rescue mechanism. All you need to do is remove the base and the faceplate on the side of the disc drive, remove this black sticker, and use a small flathead screwdriver to slowly turn the crank, which will push the disc out. 17. Kensington lock port. You ever wondered what that tiny rectangular hole is on the back of the PS5? Well, it turns out it's a Kensington lock port, which is an anti-theft device. 16. USB port C. The micro USB-C port on the front of the PS5 is probably one of the most underused functions. However, there are some clever things you can do with this port. For example, I have a USB-C hub here that I plug in, and I can add more USB-A ports to vastly increase the storage capacity of my PS5. 15. MP4 playback. Have movies or TV files that you've definitely not downloaded legally?
Are you sure about that?
That you want to watch on your PS5? Not a problem. You can use any video converter to convert them to MP4 format, which is the only format the PS5 will play. Stick them on a USB drive and plug it into the PS5, then to go to Settings, Storage, USB, and you can play the files from there. 14. Game folders and sorting. I bet you didn't know that you can not only see every game you've purchased in your game library, but you can also sort them how you please, and you can even add games to a custom game list, which is a brand new feature in the latest update as of the published date of this video. 13. Internet speed. I bet you didn't know that there's multiple ways that you could increase your upload and download speed of your PS5. The best way possible is to use an Ethernet cable and connect the PS5 directly to your router. This method will always give you the best result, but don't fret if you can't connect directly to your router. There are other ways that you can increase your internet speed. If you're using Wi-Fi, make sure the console is as close as possible to the router. And we can also increase the up and down speeds using a DNS server. To find your best DNS server, download and run DNS benchmark on your PC to get the best DNS servers, and you can manually set up the internet and enter the DNS server numbers. 12. Port forwarding. We can further increase the PS5's internet speed without an Ethernet cable using port forwarding. This is a little complex, but I'll break it down for you here. You'll need to access your router settings. You can find the login on the back of your router. Login, go to security security, port forwarding, and then check the protocol that your router uses, TCP or UDP. Then go to portforwarding.com and find the best ports for the PS5 and add a rule for each port. You should see improvements in your speed tests once you've done this. 11. The wishlist. Do you love saving money on games? Well, I sure do. We can use the wishlist on the PS Store to save money. Find a game that you want and then add it to your wishlist, and then go to Settings, Notifications, Wishlist, and enable everything. Now the PS5 will send you a notification on the app and the console whenever one of these games goes on sale. You're welcome. Number 10, accessibility. There's a whole bunch of great things that you can do in the accessibility menu to make things easier to see and read. Go Settings, Accessibility, and from here you can increase the text size, embolden text, add tick marks to the settings to make it easier to see what you've enabled, and more. Play around with the settings to get the settings perfect for you. Number 9, PS1 and 2 controllers. You can't use a PS4 controller on the PS5, but for some strange reason, you can use a PS1 and PS2 controller with compatible games. 8. The Pulse Equalizer. The Pulse headset is a great headset, but it has more power and functionality than you know. The Pulse and other compatible headsets have an equalizer function, and you can change how certain sounds are perceived. With the Pulse turned on and connected, press the PS button, go Sound, EQ Presets, and from here you can change the presets to give you an advantage in competitive PvP, or better sound quality in a PvE style game. 7. PS Plus. Okay, the existence of PS Plus isn't exactly a secret per se. However, you may not be aware of all of the benefits that come from each tier. Sony's recently revamped PS Plus to be more like Xbox Game Pass, and it is substantially better. I would highly recommend having PS Plus Basic at the very least. You get roughly £650 worth of free games. You'll get access to online multiplayer, you get access to hints, which is basically built-in video games, so you don't have to watch them on your phone or your computer anymore. And you can also get free cloud storage for your save games, so you can download and play them later if you delete your game or if you lose your data to corruption. 6. Game sharing. Have close friends that you trust? Well, using this method, you can both save even more money than before. So you need to go to Settings, Users Accounts, Other, and enable console sharing and offline play. You and your friend will need to exchange logins and passwords, so make sure you trust them. Create a profile for them on your PS5, and you can now play their games, and they can play all of yours. So if there's games that you both want to play, you can split the purchases and make massive savings. 5. Customization. If you're into customizing the look of your PS5, there's all sorts of accessories you can apply, like places from Etsy, like faceplates, decals, and lights. 4. Auto login. Annoyed by being taken to the login page every time you launch your PS5? Since you're probably the only one person that uses it, well, we can bypass this to be auto logged into a primary account. Go to Settings, Users, Accounts, Login Settings, and enable auto login. You'll automatically be logged in on launch. 3. Online and friend settings. Certain people bothering you all the time? Not a problem. From the login page, press Options, go on your profile, and you can adjust your online presence to avoid some unwanted attention. 2. Hotspotting. Your internet gone down right at the wrong moment? Don't worry, you can hotspot your PS5 from your mobile phone, and it'll only use 100 to 200 megabytes per hour, and I've tested this myself while playing PvP online and chatting in party as well. Number 1. Voice command. A relatively new feature to the PS5, it has voice commands. You can enable them in the settings menu. Simply say, "Hey PlayStation, help," to see a full list of commands the PS5 can take. Found this video helpful? Let me know what you found most interesting in the comments down below. Drop a like to help others find the video. If you want to talk to me or other PS5 users, then you should join my PS5 subreddit. There's a link on my homepage. And of course, you should subscribe for more amazing content like this. I have an entire playlist filled with videos just like this one. Check it out or watch my DualSense secret video to get the best out of your PS5 controller, and I will see you over there.